Hello and welcome to another video. So today we are taking a look at all of the new cards that have been announced for the set. Every single one of them is now up on the website, so you can check that out. I will leave a link in the description to that. We'll probably do this in a couple of parts, mainly because if I do it all in one video, it would take absolutely forever to get through every single one. So we'll do them in order on the way down, looking at each one, going through their choice cards, all that sort of thing. Tokens obviously will be a little more tricky, so I'll try and slot those in as best I can. So hopefully you guys can understand and enjoy it. And we'll get right into it with obviously the first thing, Gagdrizzle, which we did take a brief look at in the card reveals as we were going through them, but now we know everything that's being released. This is actually quite an interesting card still. Drain, Fanfare, choose one, Blessing of Creation or Wrath of Nature. Blessing of Creation here is a zero drop spell, of course. Draw two with an enhanced two, add two numbers to the play turn. That's pretty solid. And Nature's Wrath, Wrath of Nature. Give an allied follower plus one and rush. Enhance four, give all allied followers storm. Absolutely crazy if you can pull this off in some absolutely manic aggro forest deck, or even tempo forest deck would be absolutely crazy with a deck like this. So really cool to give those sort of things a try going forward. Then we have the second legendary, White Varana. I guess that's how we'll pronounce them. Sorry, my pronunciations will be shocking. I do apologize for those in advance. Anyway, it's a 6-drop 5/5 Forestcraft Legendary. Ward, if this follower attacks or defense is increased by a spell or effect during your turn, evolve this follower. The evolve has Storm and Ward, but no stat change, so it is a 5/5 Storm on evolve with Ward, so acts as a nice block and a nice finisher, which is always good. Also very easy to pull this effect off with a lot of the buff sort of cards that you get, which is really interesting, and I'm sure that this card in particular will be a fun one to mess around with in kind of a more aggressive forest decks. Then we have Swift Get Okami. So they're bringing Okami the Wolf to the Starlight of Forest, which is great. I mean, we already had one Okami card, and it's great to see another one. So when you play another follower, give it Storm, then return this follower to your hand. Awesome. So play this, give it Storm, then return this follower to your hand. Pretty good. You play this out, you play another 5-drop, for example, it gets Storm, and you attack, which is pretty nice. Could it also work really well with some like anomaly OTK sort of stuff, being able to play Swift Gambit and then follow up as soon as possible with an anomaly, especially in Unlimited, will be super cool. Then of course we have Polar Icy Warmth, 2-drop 2/2, beautiful card I think. Probably one of the nicest arts of this set so far that I've looked at. If at least two other cards were played this turn, you have at least two play points. Choose, play this card as either Polar Gentle Warmth or Polar Passionate Warmth. So Gentle Warmth is Fanfare, return an allied follower amulet to your hand. So it's basically a bounce card, which is still pretty good. I mean, the conditions aren't too difficult for this. And then Polar Passionate Warmth is deal one damage to an enemy follower, so also really nice. And the artworks actually work really well as well, with the green and red contrasting with the original blue, which I really, really enjoy. So another really solid card, I think, and definitely see some kind of pattern with both damage and storm and damage and returns, those sort of things being really popular in Forest still. Then we have Fashionista, which is another card we have looked at, but it's a 4-drop 3/4 Forest Silver. Pretty standard stat line for a 4-drop, especially a good one. Fanfare, choose, put either Angelic Dress or Demon Dress into your hand. Angelic Dress, give plus 1 to an allied follower. Well, plus 1, to an allied follower. Demon's Dress, change an enemy follower's defense to 1. So, pretty good kind of tech card, has its uses. Could definitely see it getting some play in the future. Then we've got 4-drop Spell. Forest Whispers, transform an allied follower into a fairy, put a fairy into your hand. I like transform effects, this is great for countering a lot of things. Pity it doesn't do both amulets and followers, then it would have been awesome. Would have actually been better than Fall from Grace, but in this case, fairy synergy is always a nice thing to have in Forest, so maybe slightly better than Fall from Grace unless you are specifically wanting to target amulets, so not too bad. Then we have the 3-drop Owlman. Owlman is a beautiful, beautiful card. I mean, just look at this guy. Isn't he amazing? 3-drop 2/3 silver. Fanfare enhanced 7, gain plus 4 and ambush. So basically a really solid ambush card. I can see this working in some form of tempo sort of deck or something of that sort. Probably still not the best card, of course. You're going to have some trashier ones, and honestly, I don't know if this is going to be the best, but it's definitely a fun one. Then we have Elf General, 4-drop bronze, 3-4, another one of those 3-4 stat lines that I actually quite enjoy. It has Ward and Fanfare, put a fairy into your hand. So having Ward is pretty great, especially if we do see more control sort of cards in Forest in the future, and could work out nicely. Then we have Grasshopper Conductor, 3-drop, 2-1. Fanfare, put a random follower with X attack from your deck into your hand. X equals the number of cards played this turn, including this card. So, I actually don't mind this. It's a really solid tutor. You can use it to tutor out basically anything you want, as long as you have planned it out in advance. It's a tricky one to take advantage of, but I think with the right crafting and the right mindset, you could definitely make this card work in some capacity. Then we have Servant of the Spellgrove, a 2-drop 2-2 bronze. Whenever this follower attacks an enemy follower, the enemy follower loses the ability to attack on the next turn. So, that's good. It's one of those cards, limits what your opponent can do. I always like seeing stuff like that. Then we have Flower of Fairies, a 2-drop amulet, bronze, countdown 2, fanfare, draw a card. And last word, put a fairy wisp into your hand. Put a fairy wisp into your hand if this amulet is returned to your hand. So it's another one of those return effects that we've seen on the amulets. And it has a draw effect. It is a 2 countdown, which isn't too bad. And the last word also actually works out well. So not the worst card, probably not the best card. I think it sits kind of middle ground, especially for a bronze. Then we got Swordcraft cards, which are pretty impressive, honestly. I mean, look at this Sky Fortress. It's a very interesting one. A 8-drop, 5-6, rush, fanfare, give an allied follower a 3 and a 4. So giving it a 3-4 is great stat line to give to it. If it's an officer, give it ward. If it's a commander, give it clash, draw a card. So both really good effects. The rush on its own makes it good trade value immediately, which is always nice. Commander synergy means you can pull it using other commander draw cards. Giving an allied follower is great, especially when it works on both officers and commanders, so there's no restrictions on this card at all in that regard. And of course, the extra synergy with ward and draw are both good for versatile situations, so I don't think this card's OP. That's pretty straightforward. It's definitely not an Albert, but it's interesting, and I think that's the main thing. As long as this card can see some play, I'd be very happy to see it. Then we have Sky Commander Celia, so a 2-drop 2-2 legendary. Of course, being a commander as well, if you have at least 5 play points, choose play this card as either Celia Hope Strategist or Celia Despair Manager. So Celia Hope Strategist is a 5-drop 2-4, which is always a good thing, and a pretty solid card. Fanfare, summon a Shield Guardian and a Heavy Knight. So basically going the more defensive kind of route, being able to play that off. But the more offensive style, which I think is more important, is Despair's Messenger. So it's a 5-drop 2-4 with the 4-6 evolve stat line. Storm, fanfare, gain +1 for each other allied follower in play. Then return all other allied followers to your hand, which I think is important. Returning all those followers to your hand could be quite big for Sword if they can make use of those kind of bounces, especially when you are dealing with storm damage. Then we have the gold, a 2-drop Innocent Princess Prim. It's a 1-3 gold, Swordcraft Commander. So all these cards so far have been commanders. Ambush, fanfare, enhance 8, gain +3/+3, put a Nojel Silent Mate, into your hand, and change its cost to 0. And this having ambush is important because ambush in the early game can be quite crazy, especially with good buffs. So we might look at that. I think that's a token. We'll look at that at the end of the next one. Then we have Chromatic Duel. So this is probably one of the more interesting cards for Sword, at least in my opinion. It's awesome. The 1-drop gold spell is a choose at either queen or, basically the white queen or the black queen. So their names are a bit excessive and I'm not going to go over that, but basically add either one of those. Enhance, you get to add both and recover 6 play points, which makes this card free on turn 6. You play this on turn 6, get both cards, recover 6 points. Free turn. I mean, there's nothing more to say about that. Free turns are amazing. You can also then either play the Queen of White or the Queen of Black, which is awesome. So 4-drop 3-3, pretty okay with rush. Whenever this follower attacks, summon a knight, so you're instantly getting some value out of it. And Queen Mangus is fanfare all other allied followers can't be damaged by spells and effects until the end of turn, so they're just slapping the spell and effect thing on it, which I don't think is as impressive, but if you're following this up on turn 7 with a couple of the cards, could be pretty crazy. Then we have Nojilla the Silent Maze. This is the one that goes with that other card that drops us to 0, so it's a 3-drop 2-3, Silver, Swordcraft Officer, Ward, Fanfare, gain Bane if an allied commander is in play, so gaining Bane is good, Ward is good, pretty solid and beautiful looking art, especially with those nice wings. Then we have the Vassal Magical Marksman, 3-drop 2-2 Silver Officer, Fanfare, choose, put either Holy Pure Bomb or Fatal Spell Bomb into your hand. So the Holy Pure Bomb, which has had its art updated since last time due to copyright infringement issues, I think. So 5-drop Silver, banish an enemy follower amulet. I love that. Banishing things is always great, especially if it's both amulets and followers. And Fatal Spell Bomb, which is 1-drop, destroy an enemy follower with 3 or less defense. So extremely versatile guy, honestly. Being a 3-drop and being able to set up for either turn 5 or for turn 4, or even on turn 4 or 5, you can take advantage of Fatal, which is amazing. So this guy has a lot of versatility in him, and I really enjoy a lot of these kind of cards that do this. Then, of course, we have a 2-drop 3-1 Savage Swordsman. He's an officer as well, and Fanfare Enhance 8, gain +4/+4 in Rush. So it looks like they're really pushing a lot more Rush than Storm in Sword at the moment, which isn't too surprising. After the whole Albert thing and a lot of the other Storms they've added, I'm not surprised they're pushing a more of a Rush game. But we'll wait and see where this goes, honestly. I think cards like this could have some potential, and if we can block off the boards a little bit, it could work out quite nicely. So then we have Master Samurai, the 3-drop 2-3. So good old Bronze Officer, Fanfare Enhanced 6, gain +2/+2, can attack 2 times per turn. Do love the Enhance when they can attack 2 times per turn. Honestly, I think I could come up with some crazy combos for cards like this one in particular, especially in Cursed General Sword. Wait and look out for an unlimited video on that, because I think this card plus that could be an absolute game changer. Then we have the 2-drop Holy Bear Knight, obviously is a pretty sweet looking card. Ward, Enhance 5, gain +2/+2, really pushing those enhances with a lot of these low cost cards, which I don't mind too much, especially if we end up using Sword a lot and take 2, could be quite good. Then we have the 1-drop Axe Princess. It's also actually a commander. I wasn't sure originally when I was looking at this card whether it was a commander or officer. Turns out, is a commander. Official confirmation, you heard it here. Whenever you play a card using its enhance effect, draw a card. So this is probably why they're pushing the enhance, because they can take advantage of cards like this that when using an enhance effect, you draw a card. So this one makes it a little more interesting, because you play this, play a couple of enhance cards, you get some alright draw power, which isn't something we've seen very much. And of course, the next lot of cards will be Rune. We'll probably end this video here. I'll do probably in groups of 2 mostly, until we probably get to the neutrals, where that will be a bit longer video. But hopefully you guys have enjoyed this one. All of these will go up basically one after the other, probably within half an hour to an hour of each other. So do keep an eye out for that. And I'll catch you guys in the next part of this video. See ya.